Let me go too. I've got a personal score to settle with the Klingons.
Character never became a full person.
Don't try to stop me, Captain. I saw what they left of Pyotr. I swore on his grave I would avenge his murder.
I see, you really hit a sore spot. That's the problem. The character never became a became a more dimensional person.
His brother? He never had a brother. He's an only child.
And that is the science fiction irony of my life, because as we moved on into the future, you know, we went in, not only did we do 2 years on the series, we did seven movies. And you know, technology changed and all of that was addressed in the stories that we did as the years went by. The characters themselves, Chekhov, Sulu, Scotty, Uhura, they remained in the past. They never developed.
It's to kill the pain.
And that, as I say, is the bitter irony of my experience on Star Trek. I'm not bitter. I was disappointed. I do have I am totally bonded to Star Trek, and I will take that with me to my grave, and my relationships with all the people. And I am enormously grateful for the opportunity it gave me, and for the fact that I was able to, earn a living and to support my family for those 30 years. Star Trek, because it had integrity. At its best, it had integrity. It was a show that I could feel proud about. I could feel that we're doing something that's important. Sure, we're telling fanciful stories, but we're also creating and we're giving good entertainment, and we're creating a universe that people can rejoice in. I think, and we were doing it with literacy. We were doing it with intelligence, and we were doing it with great love. So all those things made Star Trek important to me, and have continued to this day.
Mirchu Klingon Fu Lam Mur Vak Mul Ej Mokje
Vakba Me Jar Kibid Wichar
Ej Katru Wichabe Machos Lao Trikos Push Cheshevta Majahet Bobotli Shurub Kankulao
Tuchmer Bible Dillo Konak Luchev Bej Jacho Wipu
Devil Jach Jai
Devil will raj bet, Kirk. Ach devil ratir the aj. Tijat de Brooklyn on Rubo Klingon jich, chichner.
Pich has be yich ka?
Tishuv be. Not what viller, it's not natbor ved dodge rich, viller ka et vetul.
Kashtach vish wat ram loshar chur, shijlach ketbor lord. Enterprise whipacha! Whipacha bedge! Vek duj rur rak tachbog to home rach vet kop. Et lushov bid jorgan pu. Vaj klingon ho lu roj choch. Toch la. Rin lao noch vam, ma shuv e lu chao be ba o reng an pu.
Do ha chod. Kash put chuch vesh dun kuk bej.
I mean, that was the great thing that, I don't know what Roddenberry was able to do, but he found things that
in all of them, I think, that most of us had never really run into. They weren't trite. I mean, that's why it was fun to try to get on the show. The stories were always going to be something that you had not done before, and it wasn't just going to be another retelling the way we used to. You'd get do a Western and then do a cop show, and the cop show was a shirt and tie copy of the Western. That wasn't true, certainly not on this. I don't remember thinking, oh, that's familiar, or tying in with anything else.
It took risks. Gene Roddenberry's ideas were before their time. I understand that he originally wanted to use Major as the captain. And that was really, and then the network thought it wouldn't go because, to have a woman. And that, it was that kind of thing about that show.
Well, you know, there was something about the show. It seemed to me that there was something very life-affirming and very positive about Star Trek. I think it touched a lot of people because it wasn't just the fact that people were Bill and Leonard and Scotty and so on and so forth were overcoming adversity, but they were dealing with rather esoteric problems that people could sort of strange things that people could sort of hang their hats on. And they could sort of live, empathize with what the characters were doing. I mean, if you look at some of the stories, they weren't the common kind of story. They were very special.